So our scripture this week here on Tacroon Devotional comes from Matthew chapter 11 and verse 25, and I'm Keith Brown. At that time, Jesus answered and said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that you have hidden these things from the wise and the prudent and have revealed them to babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good in your sight. Now, truth many times in the Bible is kept from the wise and the prudent, or those who have self-conceit and pride. See, God is looking for those of us who will have a humble and contrite heart. He's looking for those who are submissive to Him, not people that are all pumped up in themselves. And again, yesterday we talked about the fact there's two different types of wisdom here. Notice he even uses the term. He says, but you have hidden these things from the wise and prudent. So he's not saying it's not wise, but the wisdom here comes from earth. And the Bible says that the wisdom here on earth is earthly, sensual, and demonic. We talked about it yesterday. But see, we don't want to operate according to earthly wisdom. We want to operate according to God's wisdom, which, again, is a whole different kind of wisdom. And so that is where the truth is being revealed or not being revealed. For those who, are prideful or have self-conceit and think of themselves as wise, these things are hidden from them. But to those of us who, again, have a humble and contrite heart, God wants to reveal them to us. And I'm going to show you some scripture as we continue on in this study. But let's first of all look and see that it's not just here in Matthew chapter 11 that this is revealed. But look at Romans chapter 1 and verse 18. It says, for the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who suppress the truth in righteousness, because what may be known of God is manifest in them, for God has shown it to them. For since the creation of the world, his invisible attributes are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead. Even God's eternal power and his Godhead are made manifest or revealed through his creation. That's what the scripture's saying. So it goes on to say that they are without excuse. In other words, people who say they don't know who God is and they don't really care, they're without excuse. Why? Because the creation itself screamed of God's attributes, both his eternal power and his Godhead. Amen. Goes on to say, because although they knew God, they did not glorify him as God, nor were thankful, but became futile in their thoughts, and their foolish hearts were darkened. Professing to be wise, here it is, they became fools. Why? Because they were wise in themselves, but they did not even acknowledge God. And changed the glory of the incorruptible God into an image made like corruptible man with birds and four-footed animals and creepy things. In other words, these people back then, they created molten images and they worshiped things that they created rather than the creator of them. You see? But again, God's creation screams of his attributes. And we can know God, even if you never heard the message, you still have no excuse. Why? Because God's creation speaks of him. Amen. So again, when we're talking here, we're talking about the wisdom of God and the wisdom of men. The wisdom of man wants to say, listen, I want a God who's just like me. But if you want to know the truth, I need to know God for who he is, and I need to be like him. Why? Because again, he's supernatural. Amen. Let's look at one other one. Look at 2 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 3 and 4. It says, but even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing, whose minds the God of this age has blinded, who do not believe, lest the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine on them. So in other words, without the gospel, without the light of the gospel, again, we have an adversary. His name is Satan, and he blinds our minds. He keeps us from knowing the truth. Now, you may think you're a real wise guy, right? Oh, I don't believe in God, and I don't believe in Jesus Christ, and I don't believe in heaven and hell. You can say that all you want to. It doesn't make any difference what you believe. The fact is, there is a God, there is a Jesus Christ, there is a Holy Spirit, there is a heaven and a hell. And you need to become wise, not with the wisdom of this earth, but wise with the wisdom of God. You need to study your Bible. You need to open your heart up to hear the things of God. Why? Because even His creation screams of His attributes. I'm Keith Brown. This is Tack Room Devotional. Jesus loves you. I love you. I pray that God would richly bless you as you diligently seek Him and serve Him.